I'm on a journey towards the stars, and I hope you join me. I think there's a good reason for it. I've been on this journey for 1.5 years now. Before that, I had nothing to do with space. I had not studied it, I had not done any research, I had not worked in the industry. But I'm standing here. What happened? First part of the why this all happened is life. I just love life. The picture here shows a small bird sitting on a man-made stone structure with a background of rainforest in Madeira. And actually, there's some small life growing out of the stone also. And this picture, I think, shows how complex and how wonderful life really is. I mean, those little plants are growing almost from nowhere, and the big rainforest in the background is filled with all kinds of wonderful things. And actually, the stone structure there is life happening also. We made it, us humans. Me showing this picture here to you is also life happening. So life learns and life evolves, and I can't think of anything else that would make me wonder more. But what's my relationship with life, this life that I'm, this biological chemical thing that's happening? I looked into the mirror one day when I was wondering what I want to do with my life, and I saw a man with a head and these hands that can do this, and a talking mouth, and I realized that I have superpowers. I mean, real superpowers. You all have superpowers. If we compare these to the life forms elsewhere on this planet, other life forms, other things that we can see, there's nothing like that. We can imagine the future and we can act on it. And that gives us super responsibility. Superpowers, super responsibility. And I feel responsible towards life, towards all of you. So, this is Earth, the pale blue dot. A picture from the 90s taken by the Voyager spacecraft from the outskirts of our solar system. If you look at Earth, that circled little thing over there, it looks so alone, so vulnerable, so small and tiny. All the life we know is confined on that little planet. All our eggs are basically in one basket. And I think we need more baskets. So I took that as my mission to spread life outside Earth. It's kind of a big thing. And pretty soon I faced the question, how to start? As I said, I had not worked in the industry or done anything related to space. So what does any guy in that situation do? He finds a friend and starts a blog. Starting a blog is actually a pretty good thing. It makes you come out with your passion, with this mission of mine. So it broke the ice. Before that, I was kind of intimidated talking about big things like this. Now I'm more proud, more confident about it. And pretty soon after starting this blog, I found something else while doing some research for it. It was called the International Space Apps Challenge. This is basically a huge problem-solving competition organized by NASA. And when we participated in 2013, there were something like nearly 10,000 people participating. There were a list of challenges. Me and my friends, we decided to do one called the Deployable Greenhouse, which was about building a greenhouse, sending it to Mars, and growing plants over there. And pretty soon we understood that just growing plants on Mars is not enough. We have to do a little bit better. So I'll show you a little video clip describing what happened. Mars, the final frontier. Mankind's infinite aspiration to explore has led us to colonize Mars. So, Mr. Astronaut, how is life here? You traveled months in a tin can to get here. Now you live inside a tin can and you eat from a tin can. Sounds like a good deal? Not to us. So, we decided the greenhouse can't be just a life support system. It has to provide the astronauts with a life worth living, providing oxygen, food, and a garden-like environment like this one over here. And that will save their mental health. And who are we?
Space Veggies!
In the start, there were just a couple of us. Interested guys who knew nothing about greenhouses, but something about space. We asked around for more people and ended up with over a dozen students and graduates with different fields such as physics, architecture, and agriculture.
Virtual collaboration had a key role in our work. We had four or five team members in Tampere on site all the time. One of us was working from Germany and the rest was scattered all around Finland, working from home.
And this paid off, as our concept solution shows.
We ended up with an inflatable modular dome structure in which the plants are grown in the wings and the center part provides shelter for living.
Mars is of course a somewhat hostile environment. One danger is radiation. Our idea is to blow sand on top of the structure. This reduces the transport weight of the system.
The plants themselves are grown with the hydroponic system, which can be later switched to use organic or even Martian soil.
Designing all this was great fun. And in the end, we're really proud of our concept. For more details, go check our webpage. And remember to vote for us. Yeah, that brings a lot of memories. We did actually pretty good. We won the deployable greenhouse challenge, but that was not the best thing we learned during that thing. If you wanted to do something like that, it's actually not that complicated. We started off with tools like pen and paper, a Facebook group, and some Google Docs. And when we joined the competition, what we were faced first, what we found, was this community. These thousands of people who are actually willing to do work like this for free, just to do space exploration. How wonderful. And that community actually can provide you with all the rest of the tools you need, all the skills you're lacking at that point, and so forth. It kind of supports you on this trip. And what's great also is that these kind of challenges give you access. Access to actual professionals who can help you forward with your project. For example, a bunch of amateurs like us got our project on the top of a NASA expert, and we got some feedback from him and so forth. He was mentoring us during this challenge. And if we had struck gold with one of our ideas, that would have spread through that guy to the next guy, and maybe we would have gotten funding, more research tools, resources, etc., etc. So access, that's pretty cool. But still, the best thing I learned, and I think I can speak for the team also, was about us humans. We're like cavemen still. I mean, we're smart and capable, like I told you, but we still have these prehistoric needs, primal instincts, things like that. For example, I'm sweating like in a sauna right now because I'm excited. Funny how, but it happens. So we're human, and understanding our needs is actually gold. Those needs drive the way we do business together, how we do our personal relationships, how we feel about ourselves. And that space taught me what it means to be human. Pretty cool. This is my dream. It's a picture by a guy named Rick Guidis from the 70s. It shows this kind of space torus filled with pretty much normal life. I think the best part in this picture is in the lower left corner. There's some people chatting very casually, living normal life in space. That's probably a few years in the future, but it teaches a lot. If we take that picture and we wanna create that thing, it means we have to redesign almost everything we have here on Earth and take it to space. If we wanna obey those needs we have, and I think we have to. Let's take an example. We've seen actually pretty many good examples about this during this evening, for example, the robot. But let's take a simpler example, like that shirt the girl is wearing over there. If we want to have that shirt in space, it can't be made like we do here on Earth. We can't grow massive amounts of cotton with using huge amounts of water. We have to do it in a simpler, more sustainable way. And if we design for space, I think we can actually do better designs for Earth, and that will pay back sooner than later. And doing that kind of design is not a job for a rocket scientist, well, only a rocket scientist or a robot engineer. We need all kinds of skills. I mean, really, all kinds of skills. If we're talking about space hotels, we need someone who decorates them and makes them more comfortable and, you know, fun to live in. We need all kinds of skills. So, why to start doing space stuff? It'll pay back globally, universally even, we'll get life to continue, and personally, we learn about ourselves, we learn about other people, and the place, the universe we're living in. So, I say let's embrace that challenge. Thank you.